Hi Kunal, hi Zaheer. Tell me about the whole the germ of Ketto for you.
Well, the germ of it, you know, I was working very closely with a number of NGOs, and I found that these NGOs constantly had challenges that they faced. Primary was that, you know, once an NGO had reached out to a donor for a donation for a project that they were doing, it was very difficult to constantly keep reaching out to the same people, because once someone's donated, you know, it's very unlikely that they're going to donate again. I felt like they needed to, first of all, reach out to new donors, which was challenging for these NGOs. If you wanted to get more people involved, especially young people. So with that thought in our minds, that was when I started doing sort of research on how people go about it out west, and I came across the concept of crowdfunding. And I felt like this was, you know, perfect, because if we spend so much time on our smartphones, on our computers, on our electronic devices, if we could use that time to actually help somebody, I felt like it could be great. So the idea really was to use technology to connect people that can help to people that need helping. And that's where Ketto fits in.
And just to also add is, inherently India has always faced a problem of transparency when it comes to social causes.
Right.
And you know, just the thought that everything is online, everything is free for anyone to see what is happening. If you've seen most of our pages on Ketto, we try to portray as much information on the page as possible so that people know exactly what's happening. And people, we get this feedback a lot, where people really appreciate the fact that you are taking money from us, but you're also letting us know exactly what's happening with our money, which was kind of blindsided the past in India. So I think transparency brings in a lot of willingness to come forward and contribute.
How did you and Varun, when you guys started, decide on what kind of causes would Ketto support? And if Zaheer, you could add that over the years, which has been that area where you felt was the most important and most used in Ketto?
The idea was that, you know, we didn't want to sort of say that these are the only causes that we're going to work with, because different things work for different people. People have different requirements, and also as donors and individuals that want to help, I think, you know, we all look out for different causes. So you might want to support education, he might want to support health, I might want to support movies. So we've never restricted the causes. What we've done is, when we started off, is that we vetted the NGOs really closely, which means that, you know, we asked for all their documentation, made sure that the NGOs were verified, you know, the NGOs were doing good work. And which is only after going through that whole process did we decide that we wanted to list them on the platform.
Yeah, and just to add to Kunal's thing, yes, we are primarily a social crowdfunding platform. We are cause agnostic, however. The entire ethos of Ketto is that if anyone needs funds for a cause that is legitimate or it is deemed legitimate by the crowd, we want to help them raise money and democratize raising money in general by activating the crowd of India.
So Zaheer and Kunal, I wanted to know from both of you, each story on Ketto which really is close to your heart.
Well, there's been so many. I mean, there's been a right from, you know, raising money for athletes that wanted to go for the Commonwealth Games, Asian Games, for them winning golds there. You know, those of course are really special. But the one that really touched me was that there was this dancer called Tara Balagopal. Right, so her story was in the papers, and we had started a campaign for her. And there was this one person that came and started a fundraiser for her. He was a lawyer from Delhi. And Tara Balagopal was this really celebrated dancer. I mean, she was the sort of person that people lined up to see. She had won numerous government awards. You know, ministers wanted to watch her dance. You know, she was really, really celebrated. And when we saw her story, she was physically very sick. You know, she was living in a house where the food that she was eating was possibly a month old. It was lying in the fridge. She had, of course, you know, mentally also, she wasn't all there anymore. And this man that raised money for her, he ended up raising, I think, 8.5 lakhs for her. And then I visited Tara Balagopal's house to see what had happened. And the whole house had changed. So he had redone her house. There was a new fridge. There was a cook that was there all day cooking food for her. He had a nurse that was taking care of her physically. He was a lawyer. So he was fighting a case against the government to get her pension back. And he had almost become like a son to her. And I asked him, you know, why did you do this? And he said that he had lost his father a couple of years back. And he felt like he wanted to help this lady. And so random stranger, doesn't know her, and he's turned her life around. And that for me was really, really powerful because I had a chance to see it personally. I had a chance to see the before and after pictures and how her house looked and how she was living, and it had completely changed. And really, it was just really sort of moving for me to see that.
Right. Very cliche question, but I have to ask this, that 5 years down the line, where do you see Ketto going, and are there things in your mind, Kunal, that you want to bring in and add into Ketto?
Well, you know, I think honestly, we've just scratched the surface. Crowdfunding is a very sort of nascent industry. In fact, when we started about 5-6 years back, nobody had even heard of it. Yeah, so it was a big challenge because it was not only about educating the NGOs that wanted to raise the money, but also, you know, educating people that wanted to donate on the platform. So we believe that we've just really just scratched the surface. You know, there's a lot more awareness that needs to be created. Like he was saying, is that a lot of people, this is something that can help a lot of people, but they don't even know it exists. So really educating people, creating awareness, you know, that I think is our primary focus. Now, having said that, we'd also like to explore going into different countries. That is something that we speak about and we've spoken about regularly. I think those two are our main agendas right now.
Zaheer, you want to add?
So of course, I'll speak a little more technically about this, because with the advent of artificial intelligence and machine learning, etc., that is happening worldwide now, and it is really bringing a lot of efficiency into daily operations and daily processes. So how do we leverage more and more of technologies every day to effectively, you know, actually at some point we've also discussed with the whole blockchain movement that's going on, we've also discussed of how do we make this process more transparent for our donors by actually employing or using parts of the blockchain as a technology. So the goal is that we have, as Kunal absolutely rightly hit the nail on the head by saying that we've only scratched the surface so far in India. And the biggest validation again of our hypothesis is that people are willing to give.
Right. Thank you, Kunal.
Thank you, Zaheer.
I have this clear mindset about Ketto and about one platform where if I ever want to donate or if I want to raise funds, I know where I have to go. So thank you so much, and keep up the good work.
Thank you.